Let's just take a quick look at some of the tools we provide you with to make capture really, really fast. So most supply chains start from a capture event. So let's just drag one of those into the canvas. So dragging and dropping creates a new node. If I want to create the next node in my supply chain, I could drag a node from the palette, drop it, and drag an edge in order to connect those two things together. That can be quite slow. So we've also enabled you to drag an edge from a node, click in white space, and it will automatically create the next node in the chain for you. When I have a node selected, I can use the scroll on my mouse wheel and it will toggle through the subtypes available for that particular node. So at the end of the supply chain, I might want an outcome node. I can create more information outcomes from an action simply by clicking, dragging in white space, and I'll create more information nodes, which I might want to connect to more outcomes. If I have a supply chain being captured and I realize I've missed something, I can quite simply drag a node from the palette, drop it on the edge, and you'll notice the edge changed color. When I let go, that node will be inserted into the supply chain. So it's really, really quick to build the information flow aspect of the supply chain. When it comes to connecting the enablers of the flow, people and systems, this is also really straightforward. Drag the node from the canvas, hold it over the node you want to connect to. You'll get the black handles around the edge of a node. When you let go, the node will be connected for you. The same with systems onto people, and maybe systems against an action, systems against information. This process is really simple. So now, as we go about capturing the supply chain, the job we have to do is make sure that we are labeling each of these nodes as we have the conversation with people inside our organization.